As I was trained to do, though, I tactically reloaded. I dropped my mag. I kept my eyes down on range. I kept my weapon up. I recharged my weapon and was going to readdress the passenger, who was still not completely, he's still moving around a little bit. As I'm going toward him, and the idea was there, is I felt it was necessary for me to get very close and make sure that I neutralized that threat. Help had arrived, and they're hollering at me for cover at this point. And it was kind of like when I'm at home on Sundays and watching the Cowboys play, and my wife's talking to me. I knew something was happening back there. In any case, they finally did get my attention. I was in a whole other zone, trust me. My focus was not on what was happening over there. They got my attention, brought me to a safe place to cover, and things played out very well. Now, the only injury we had, other than the unfortunate demise of these two good men, was a security guard. He did take a round through his calf that was probably a ricochet. I'm telling you, if you're going to get shot by an AK-47, that's the way to do it. Because he went to the hospital, they cleaned him up a little bit. I'm sure they gave him an antibiotic and a band-aid, and that was about all it took. So, you know, the Lord was looking after me too. But the important thing about this story, there's a couple of things. One of the most important things, though, what I really like to stress about this, and especially when I get a chance to, not just to great folks like yourself, but law enforcement too, I like to stress the fact that training is the key to being prepared for these kind of things. I always like to say, you know, you got to prepare in different ways. One, you got to prepare in your hands, right? That means you got to go to the, and I don't care what you're training for, whether it's defensive tactics, firearms, report writing, whatever it is, whatever hobbies you, golf, for instance. If you don't practice golf, you're not going to be any good at it, right? So training is key, but you got to train in your hands. And that's the muscle memory and so on. Equally as important, you got to train in your head. You got to plan. You got to plan scenarios. If you're protecting your congregation at this church, you need to have a plan. If something happens, what are we going to do? We don't need to be making a plan when it happens. The plan needs to already be in place so that the plan gets executed efficiently. In the same way, that's true in law enforcement, it's true whether you're doing a security plan for your church or whatever you're doing. But you got to prepare in your hands, you got to prepare in your head. Know in advance what you're going to do. But something that's really important too is you got to be willing, and you got to be prepared right here in your heart. Preparing in your hands, preparing in your head, that helps you prepare right here in your heart. I'm no specially trained, or there's nothing particularly unique about me. I'm just like everybody else in this room, and everybody else in this room put in the same position as I was, prepared the same way that I was, could have the same result. Now, there is the reality, and I want to be sure to pass this on to you. I'm going to close on this. I stand here before you, telling you the story by the grace of God.
Amen.
I'll tell you right off the bat, Greg Stevens isn't good. You know, there's nothing special about Greg Stevens, and Greg Stevens just did what he was trained to do. God reached down, put his hand on my shoulder that day, and said, "Look, I'm going to take care of you, but you're going to have to take care of those guys."